Well, welcome back. If you're joining us a little bit later, if you've been since the beginning, we're having a healing day. We're having a love healing day. Enough doom and gloom for this week. As I said, yes, we need to be aware of what's going on in the world around us, but it doesn't mean that we have to have it control us. And that's what today is all about. And there is only one law, a law of all that is or all that ever will be, and that is creation love that's within us. So today is the day to let it out. And the words, I'm going to repeat what I said in the first half hour, and these words are powerful. If you were here the first half hour, I know you know how powerful they were because it got you into thinking, and all of a sudden you felt that light, that living light, begin to well up inside of you. I know it because it happens with me every time I read it. It's words that are very powerful. The harmonics, they're logos, they awaken your sleeping spirit. And love is all that creation and living light and the life cross, that's what it's all about. Not the worldly love, real love, which brings real joy and real peace. Not worldly peace, not fake joy of the world, and not a love that the world only tries to imitate from the real thing. It's time for us to wake up that true love that's within us and let it overcome all the things that the world throws against us. If you need today, the minute that you're hearing this broadcast, archived or not, there is no time relationship in love. And there is no time relationship in spirit. Light is light. It transcends every time of time barrier, every kind of time barrier that man could throw at it. There is no time in truth, and there is no time in love. So whatever you need right now, especially those who are just saying, you know, the whole world seems to be crashing down around me. I don't know how much more of this garbage I can take. Everything seems to be going wrong. Everything seems to be against me. And when I try to do good in the world's ways, then something comes along to make it even worse. Well, today is your day. Today, you're going to have true creation love spoken into your soul. And whether you think it does anything or not, when I read this again, what you think really doesn't matter. You will know in your heart, in your spirit, it's going to get excited. Those who listened to it the first time, you got excited. That's why you're still hanging on. That's why you want to hear it again. If you just get one sentence out of this and take it to heart, it will change your life. It will heal your broken heart. It's that simple, and that's what's going to happen. So sit back. If you're in your car, turn off the radio. If you're listening to this on your computer, just close the door, wherever you're at, just get silent and listen. Listen to the words, close your eyes, and absorb the logos. Absorb love spoken. So let's go. The law of all that is. Love is the law of all that is or ever will be. You live that you may learn to love. You love that you may learn how to live. No other lesson is required of all of humanity but that. Who or what is any one of us to love? Are you only to choose a certain leaf from the tree of life and give that one leaf all your heart? Well, what about the branch that bears that leaf? What about the stem that holds that branch? What about the bark that shields that stem? And what are the roots that feed the bark and the stem and the branches and the leaves? And then what about the soil that embraces the roots and of the sun, the sea, and even the air that fertilize the soil that embraces the roots that feed the bark, the stem, and the branches and the leaves? If one small leaf on a tree is worthy of your love, then how much more is the entire tree worthy of that same love? A love that singles out a fraction of the whole predestines itself to grief and sorrow. Some leaves are healthy, but some are sick. Some are magnificent and beautiful, and some are plain and ugly. Some are giants, and some are small dwarfs. Because of this, people say, well, how can we not help but pick and choose? Well, the reality of truth says this. From the paleness of the sick proceeds the freshness of the healthy. Ugliness is beauty's palette, beauty's paint, and brush. And the dwarf would not be a dwarf unless he had given of his stature to the giant. You are the tree of life. Beware of fractioning yourselves. Never set fruit against fruit, a leaf against a leaf, or a bough against a bough, or a stem against the roots, or the tree against the soil, the mother. But that's what you do when you love one part more than the rest. Or worse yet, to the exclusion of the rest. You are the tree of life. Your roots are everywhere. Your boughs, branches, and leaves are everywhere. Your fruits are in every mouth. Whatever the fruits on that tree may be, whatever its boughs and branches and leaves may be, whatever the roots may be, they are your fruits. They are your leaves, your branches, your boughs, and your roots. If you want your tree to bear sweet and fragrant fruit, and if you want it to be strong and green and mighty, then you have to pay attention to the resin, the lifeblood of your tree. Love is the lifeblood of life. It is the resin of your tree. Love is the resin of life. Love is the blood that must circulate unhindered in your veins. If you repress your blood, it becomes a plague. Hate is love repressed or love withheld. Hate becomes a deadly poison, not only to the one feeding the hate, but also to one who is fed by hate, to the hater and to that which is hated. A yellow leaf appearing on your tree of life is a love-starved leaf. So don't blame it on the leaf. A withered branch on your tree of life is a love-starved branch. So don't blame it on the withered branch. a rancid fruit on your tree of life is a fruit that grew in hatred. Don't blame it on the fruit. The blame rests on a blind and stingy heart that would dole out the blood of life to just a few while denying it to many. In doing this, it denies blood to its own self. No love is possible except by love of the entire self, the entire tree. No self is real except the all-embracing self, the entire package, the whole tree. So therefore, all is love, because all loves all that is. All is love, because all loves all that is. If love hurts you, then you've not found the reality of the whole. Nor have you found the key of love. Because you love an external self, your love becomes external. The worldly love of a man for a woman is not love. It's a distant token of real love. The love of a parent for their child is only the threshold to love. Until every man is every woman's lover, and every woman is every man's lover, and until every child is every parent's child, and every parent's child is every child, then let men and women continue to brag only of their flesh and bone, clinging to nothing more than flesh and bone, but never speak the sacred name of love in its place. You have no friends if just a single man is your enemy. How can a heart that harbors enmity be a safe home for a friendship? You don't know the joy of love if there is hatred in your heart. That which you hate is bound up inseparably with that which you love. You cannot break the two apart, like the head and the tail of the same coin. If you are truly honest with yourself, then you must love what you hate, and you must love what hates you. And you must do that before you can love what you love and what loves you. Love is not a virtue. It's a necessity of a greater importance than bread and water, and more important than even lighter air. Let no one have pride in their loving. You should inhale and exhale love just as unconsciously as you breathe in and breathe out air. Love needs no one to exalt it. Love will only exalt the heart that finds worthy of itself. Don't seek out rewards for love, because love is rewarded sufficiently with love, just as hate is a sufficient punishment for hatred. Love accounts to no one but itself. Love neither lends nor borrows, and love doesn't buy or sell. But when love gives, it gives all, the whole, everything. And when it takes all, the whole, everything. Its very taking is giving, and its very giving is taking.